System overview. The system comprises of two views, namely the formation view and display view. The formation view mainly contains a confrontation matrix, narrative common line, and two formation flows. The confrontation matrix presents confrontation situations specified by pairwise formations of two teams. For instance, the highlighted cell represents a formation pair where team A is using 2-3-2-3 and team B is using 4-2-3-1. The frequency of formation pairs encoded by the luminance of cells. We use a bar chart to show the frequency of formations for each team. The glyph of each formation is placed on providing connections. When we hover on each cell, the corresponding elements will be highlighted. We can hide or unhide the matrix by clicking the matrix button. The narrative timeline progresses from left to right. We divide the timeline into two pieces to represent the first and the second half of the game. The demonstration of the event glyphs is shown in the legend above. Users can hover on each event glyph for details. Two bar charts on the timeline shows the involvement of two teams' performance. The higher, the worse. The formation flow in the series is the formation changes of each team. The y-coordinate of flow encodes its relevant position in the formation. The thickness encodes the number of players in the corresponding spatial area. The split of merge of subflows represents the change of formations. For example, at time 1, subflow A, B, and C represent forward, midfield, and back of the formation respectively, and the formation is 4-4-2. At time 2, subflow A splits into two subflows. One of subflow merges with subflow B. This means a player in the forward moves to the midfield at time 2, which causes a formation change from 4-4-2 to 4-5-1. Additionally, we also place the glyph of substitution on formation flows. The arrow pointing out from the subflow represents a player to leave. The other represents a player to substitute. We can scroll on formation flows to zoom in and zoom out. We can click on the board pass button to display the board positions among the flows between the two teams. We can click on the player on the peer to see his movements with formations. Moreover, we can hover on a matrix cell and the corresponding formation pair will be highlighted in two flows.
Case study.
At the beginning, the timeline shows the outline of the game. Brazil scored 2 goals first, yet Argentina hit 3 goals in the second half and turned the tide. To analyze the game, we turn to the confrontation matrix to obtain an overview of formations. We quickly notice 3 dark cells representing 3 formation pairs. Among them, formation 2-3-2-3 is an attacking formation featuring pass and control. Formation 4-2-3-1 is important to augment defense, and formation 4-4-2 is for counterattack. Then we move to team performance indicators. The render chart shows that two teams were similar in board position time, yet Argentina had far more passes representing a pass control style. We hover over matrix cells and find that Brazil employed 4-4-2 for defense and counterattacked in the first half, while they turned to formation 4-2-3-1 to focus on defense in the second half, especially that of midfield. Argentina equalized the score at the beginning of the second half, which is the turning point of this game, so we zoom in for further analysis. In this period, Brazil mainly maintained 4-4-2 for counterattack, in addition to moving its striker back forward to change from 4-4-2 to 4-5-1 for increasing the defense. By expecting flip player flows, we know that the dropping striker was player 11, a shadow striker in formation 4-4-2. Thereafter, we combine game situations for further analysis. After continuous attacks from Argentina, Brazil eventually regained the ball and passed the ball to the striker for a quick attack. At that moment, however, Argentina failed to change to a defensive formation in time. Argentina's poor defensive performance was also indicated in its high average area value. Moreover, they even hit an own goal. Despite that, Argentina persists in attacking tactic, forcing Brazil changing from formation 4-4-2 to 4-5-1 for deep defense. It seemed to be a successful strategy such that they seize the chance and score a goal. To verify this goal, we select the period of this goal on the timeline and turn to the display view for more details.
Thanks for watching.